The kid does something involving the neighbor's lawn, littering, throwing a piece of paper, nothing, who knows, but did something, aggravates the neighbor. The neighbor grabs the kid. The mother gets upset, calls 911. The cops come, and then let's play the piece of video again that is operative here that only shows the interaction between the cop and the mom. So you have what is legal here, what the law is supposed to do, and then you have how you're supposed to police. Let's start with the policing first. The idea of getting a call like this, and when the mother is talking to you about it, you ask her about how she raises her kid. Is that, for us who aren't in the police community, is that as dumb as it seems for someone who was in the police community?
Yes, it's pretty dumb. The main thing here, when I first saw this video, the first thing I thought in my head was, who broke this guy in? My God, this officer doesn't even know how to react to a situation like this. It's clear the mother called the police. We see him walking from the white male in the beginning of the video like he's talking to the white male first. Now, I'm wondering, you know, who made the call to the police? Because if he's talking to the white, yeah, but also there's another report that he also called the police also. Something after that. So when the call came in, was it because he was a complaint or she was a complaint? Either way, all right, when he got there and he confronted the mother about what happened, and let me tell you, what really annoyed the hell out of me was his comment where she says, it doesn't give him the right to put his hands on me. And the officer says, why not?
Right.
I was like, I was floored. I tell you, Chris, I wanted to smack this officer myself for his stupidity and the way he acted. Now, my analysis is based on this video and this video alone, but I think this video shows pretty much everything that was going on. This police officer is bordering misconduct, maybe even criminality in this certain incident.
Could anything have happened that you don't know that would have made what the officer says and does with respect to the mother okay?
It's kind of hard because you can see the point where the daughter comes to grab the mother. Why the officer put his hands on her, I have no idea. It was clear to me that, you know, the mother started getting mad, and it looks like the daughter tried to come in to intervene and keep her mother, you know, started to make her mother calm down. Then the officer just grabbed her like that. I was just, like, shocked, you know. And like I said, this is poor training. Has this guy got, like, 2 weeks on the job, or has he been on for 5 years?
And then you have the criminal procedure part, the legal part. If I call you, or let's keep to the fact pattern, if the mother calls and says, the guy grabbed my son by the neck, what triggers the bar for probable cause to make an arrest in a situation like that?
Well, at that point, Chris, you would have to assume that the mother has given the officer probable cause in that situation, barring any sort of unforeseen circumstance that we haven't seen where someone says, you know, there's a litany of other witnesses that are saying that this is not true, that this is not what happened. But presumptively, after having placed a 911 call, being on the scene, there's no reason to believe that that officer may have thought that this woman was not telling the truth. And so from everything that I've seen on this video, that officer absolutely had probable cause to effectuate an arrest on the gentleman who was called on by the police. And so when I watched this video, I'm really wondering, what was the question? What was the issue that the officer had? Even with respect to what you were talking about with regarding that woman's raising of her child, that's not relevant to what was going on in that situation.